Come on, Howie. Come on, let's go. Let's do it.
The rifles.
No, we can overwhelm them. We easily outnumber their bullets.
This is it.
Curtis, come on. We're out of time, buddy. You gotta do it now.
They've got no bullets!
Book that I read was Snowpiercer by Jacques Laub.
And Snowpiercer is about the people on this train who, 18 years after the world was sent into an ice age, are just trying to survive, and Curtis there, he doesn't like the way the people in the back of the train are being treated.
So the book is about this guy, his name is Curtis, and he wants to rebel against the front of the train. Now there were rebellions in the past, like this one, where people jumped outside the train, but they all failed.
But Curtis has been planning for weeks and weeks, and he coordinates all of the people in the back to build a contraption to block all the doors so that they have enough time to get out of their section of the train and into the upper parts of the train, where there they can move from car to car and slowly take out all the people getting to the front of the train and take over the engine. And the reason that all past rebellions have failed is because nobody was able to take the engine. And that's Curtis's main plan. He wants everybody to work together and get to the engine. In order to do this, he has to have some help from the person who built the security systems for the train, who is currently held up in the jail section of the cell. So the top priority is to free him from jail, then move on. The theme that I put for this book was freedom, because the people in the back of the train do not have as many rights as the people in the front of the train. They live in poverty and filth and muck, while the people in the front have a lavish lifestyle. They get regular food like chicken and turkey, while the people in the back of the train get fed something called protein blocks, which are actually made up of a bunch of squished up bugs put into a block and then cooked. And today in the world, there's a lot of fighting going on in a lot of countries overseas, because some people aren't actually as privileged as us, because they don't have the freedom that we do. Places such as Tibet, Uzbekistan, Turkmenistan, Sudan, and Somalia all have to fight for their freedom because it's not given to them. It's not their birthright. They don't know what it's like to be able to have things like the freedom of speech. And it is estimated in the world about 25% of countries are not free, whereas 30% of countries are partially free. Some countries who have recently gained independence are Armenia, Cambodia, and the Czech Republic, who only gained independence around 20 years ago. So by the end of the movie, Curtis and the people of the back eventually push all the way to the front of the train, where Curtis meets Wilford, and he tells him that he planned the entire uprising to happen and that he wants Curtis to take off the train. And all this time, the person who built the security doors, who was helping Curtis, wanted to blow up a door on the train, and he wanted to escape because he says that after all these years, the snow has actually been melting. And so they light the bomb, which blows up part of the train, causing an avalanche to happen. And the avalanche races down the hill, hits Snowpiercer, derails the whole thing, cars go flying off a cliff, the whole thing just crashes down. And after the dust had settled and everything was gone and the whole train was derailed, only two people survived. The daughter of the head security guy and a random kid who happened to be running the train. And after they climb out of Snowpiercer, they both see a polar bear, so that you know everything is hopefully